The things that are particularly exciting about the division, we're busy doing building next generation numerical weather prediction systems. We're building state of the science data assimilation systems. We're using observations that kind of nobody else in the world has access to, trying to figure out how to use those things. We're developing prediction systems for aerosols that nobody else is worried about. We're building decision tools for warfighters. We're going out and going on submarines, we're going on aircraft carriers, we're going to Japan, we're going to Hawaii, we're going to the Caribbean, we're going all over the world to try to understand phenomenology, try to capture that phenomenology and predict it and provide to the warfighter so that they can make better decisions.
We have a special version of the Navy's limited area model, which is called COAMPS, the Coupled Ocean Mesoscale Prediction System. In this special version, we've developed to predict a tropical cyclone. COAMPS is one of the most flexible limited area models in the world. This model is set up in a way that is extremely flexible to support the Navy and DoD and produce accurate forecasts of the weather. Any part of the planet is coupled to an ocean model and a wave model. This sort of tight coupling is really unique and is one of the strengths of the Navy in terms of our science and also our ability to support the warfighter.
I've been doing research since 2013 on an atmospheric phenomenon called pyrocumulonimbus. It's a wildfire-driven thunderstorm. It's actually triggered by the intense heating from large wildfires. There's no prediction available for these events, and some of them even inject smoke into the lower stratosphere where the smoke particles can persist for weeks or months. So you end up with a large smoke plume being transported downwind into regions that you otherwise wouldn't expect. Our primary goal is to understand the mechanisms driving these events, their impact on atmospheric composition, with the goal of eventually producing a prediction system for PyroCB that can be rolled into the Navy's aerosol forecasting system.
I was funded to study how dust impacts the Caribbean population. So the dust actually originates from Africa, the northeast deserts, the Saharan deserts, and it lifts high into the atmosphere up to about 18,000 feet. And then the trade winds, or basically the northeast winds, carry that dust across Africa into the Atlantic, and it goes for thousands of kilometers all the way over to the Caribbean, northern South America, the Gulf of Mexico, and southeastern US. This Saharan air layer project spans a variety of disciplines. It's not just meteorology, it's combines hydrology, it combines a lot of math, high-level math, which translates to a lot of modeling possibilities, a lot of instruments, instrumentation. So it basically takes everything that you can think of in meteorology, but we also need a lot of computer savvy.
My work with Triton is developing a tool that our Navy forecasters can use, which really speeds up how fast that they can produce forecasts and maximizes their impact. The tool is an online website, basically. So the forecaster will go to a web address, fill in the flight information of where the Triton is going in the world, and basically that tool then goes to our Navy models, NavGem, which is a numerical weather prediction model that forecasters pull, and it will look at where the Triton is flying through that model in four-dimensional space. A good Navy forecast will look at the numbers. If they disagree with it, they'll alter it, and then they can hand that off to the pilots. Weather information is important, and it's actually more important than what you think it is. A lot of systems that our military uses are highly dependent on the weather, so it is a vital aspect of our national defense.
NRL and FENMOC are unique and serve kind of two different purposes. NRL is sort of the R&D, research and development wing of the Navy, and then FENMOC will take the products that are developed at NRL and actually put them into operation. So that's where COAMPS and the different weather modeling products actually go, and they're run for the end user, for the warfighter and the folks on the ship, where they can reach back to FENMOC, access these products, and then be able to know what the weather forecast is. What I do is I'll use the numerical weather prediction products, or NWP products, that are developed here at NRL, and use them to drive electromagnetic or EM propagation models, so we can forecast how different EM sensors will perform, like the radar on a Navy ship or electromagnetic communication.
Right, so marine meteorology really is the atmospheric expertise. So we build the atmospheric models for the Navy, for Navy prediction. The oceanography division down at Stennis builds the ocean and ice models. The divisions out in DC, both remote sensing and space science, are working on the high altitude component. The research with our Earth System Prediction Capability, which is ESPC, is where we're all working together to build this coupled system where the atmosphere and the ocean and the ice realms, models, all talk together. And this is going to be a completely new capability for the Navy that we've never had before.
It's always a pleasure to be able to see your research go to operations and be used by service members in this nation. And hopefully you'll one day hear that your product, the products that you developed, save some lives.
The group of people that work here, I think I really like that. And there is a lot from all different kinds. There's a lot of people that do a wide variety of people that do like theoretical work, but there's also a lot of application work, a lot of people that work with instruments. So basically you can learn from a wide amount of people, a little bit of them. So I really like that you have a lot of resources in learning, because I feel like, you know, all the knowledge that we collect is actually doing something for somebody, and that's what you want. You want your all your research to be productive for, in this case, for the Navy, and that's very exciting to see.
It's important to have a diverse workforce, because that diversity of background, that diversity of culture, that diversity of thought enables the best decisions. And if you can get more people in the room with more background and more ideas, and you have an environment and a culture where everybody is, you know, comfortable and feels safe putting their ideas out on the table, you're gonna end up with a better solution, you're gonna end up with better decisions. And as a division, we're gonna be more successful in helping the Navy and helping the country.